गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज एलन सर इज हियर, योर कंप्यूटर टीचर, एंड हियर आई एम स्टार्टिंग चैप्टर 6, इटरेशन और अ लूप। सो फर्स्ट, व्हाट डू यू अंडरस्टैंड बाय अ लूप? सो इट इज यूज टू एग्जीक्यूट वन और मोर स्टेटमेंट रिपीटेडली टिल अ कंडीशन इज सेटिस्फाइड। दिस इज कॉल्ड अ लूप। It is also called a iteration. So loop is just like a closed cycle when a statement will be start from beginning to end, and this will be again start from go to the starting point, and this will be repeated task. And there should be a condition. If we will not mention any condition in the loop, then this will be infinite loop. So basically a loop is used for writing a one statement single time, and this will be execute multiple time based on the condition. Now Java provide the two types of loop. Number first is pre-tested, and this is also called a entry control loop. As the name is suggest, pre-tested. So in this loop, first the condition will check, then loop body execute. Pre-tested means first the condition will be checked, then the loop body execute. If the condition is fail, this loop will not execute. And the example of this is for and while. Another type of loop is that is the post-tested, and this is also called a exit control loop. In this loop, first loop body execute, then condition check. So if the condition is fail, this loop execute at least once, because first the loop body will be execute, then the condition is check. So if the condition is fail, this will be execute at least one time, because after first iteration this will check the condition. And the example of this is do while. So basically there are the two types of loop. One is a pre-tested, second one is post-tested. In pre-tested there are the two type of loop. One is a for and second one is while. And in post-tested there is only a single loop, that is do while. Now what are the parts of loop? So every loop, whether the loop is a pre-tested, post-tested, means a loop is a for loop, while loop or do while loop, every loop have a four parts. Number first is a initialization. Initialization means this is the starting point of loop, so from where the loop will be start. Second is the test expression. This is also called a condition, till where the loop will be execute. Third is a body of the loop, and last is the update expression. This is also called a increment or a decrement. Now what are the major difference between a for loop and while loop? What are the example of pre-tested? And now what are the difference between a for loop and while loop? So in for loop, number of iterations is fixed, whereas in while loop, number of iterations is not fixed, or we can say unknown. So what is the meaning of fixed and not fixed? When we will see any for loop, within a second we will calculate how many times of this loop will be executed. So we will say a number of iteration is fixed. Whereas in while loop, we required the more time for calculating, then we will find out how many times this loop will be executed. Difference: for loop is used for fixed number of iteration, whereas while loop will be used where number of iteration is unknown. Or if we can say what are the similarity between a for and while, so there is a similarity. Both are the example of pre-tested loop or entry control loop. In this, first the condition will be checked, then the loop body will be executed. Now here, this is the syntax of for loop, so I am explaining in detail for loop. So the syntax is for, and there will be the initialization inside the bracket, then test expression, then update. In this, there will be only the two semicolon between the statements. Before the first semicolon, there will be the initialization, and before the second, there will be a test expression. And this is the body of loop. Here may be a single statement or a multiple statement. If we want to execute a single statement, then curly bracket is not required. Or if there is the more than one statement, it's based on the loop, then curly bracket is required. Let's see the example of this. Suppose a loop for we want to print from 1 to 5 using a for loop. So we will write for I equal 1. So this is the initialization. This will come here. I is less than equal 5. So in the first, I is 1. 1 is less than equal 5. Condition is true. Then this will come to the down. So first will be 1 will be printed. Then this will be come here. And the loop will be increased by 1. So the value of I will be 1. After that, this will check the condition. If the condition is true, then again this will repeat it, otherwise this will exit from a loop. So second time 2 is less than equal 5, condition again is 2, then 2 will be printed, and this will be in vertical because we are using SOPLN statement is here. Then 3, again the condition is 2, then 4, again the condition is 2, then 5, again the condition is 2 equal, and when the value will be increased by 1, so this will become a 6. Now the condition is false, so this will exit from a loop. And in the first, we are not using the curly bracket, so this will be also executed because here is the one statement. Or we can also use a one curly bracket in a single statement, but for a single statement, curly bracket is not required. And now there are the different formats of, let's take another example. Suppose we want to print the values in decreasing order. So we are starting here from I equal 5, I is greater. When the loop will be in decreasing, so condition will be opposite. I is greater equal 1, then I minus 1. So 5, 5 is greater 1, condition is 2, then 1 will be 5 will be printed. Again, the value will be decreased by 1, then condition is 2, 4 is greater 1. So the value will be printed 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Till the one is condition is true. After that the value will be decrease, so the value will be 0. 0 is greater equal 1, the condition is false, then this will exit from the loop. Now there are the different formats of for loop. Number one is a infinite loop, second is a empty loop, third is a multivariable loop, and last is a skip statement loop. So we will see the formats of for loops in details in next lecture, or just I am explaining here the only first one, that is the infinite loop. The meaning of the infinite loop is if the loop is a endless, or we can say a loop without condition is called a infinite loop. Example, for I equal 1, we are skipping here the condition, then I plus plus, then SOPLN. So I equal 1, this will check the condition, and there is the no condition, so this will execute the body. I plus plus, this will be increased, then again come on the condition, there is the no condition, so this will loop will be execute till infinite. So the answer will be in this format 1, 2, 3 till infinite times. Or if there is the condition is wrong, or we can say and decrement, so this a loop may be also a infinite. I equal 1, and we are here writing I minus minus, so that next value will be 0 and minus 1 and so on. So always this condition will be true, so this is also an infinite loop.